Hello, I hope everybody's doing great today. This video, I'm going to do some of my DIY hunting clothes. I don't have any problem with commercially made camouflage. It's just the level of satisfaction I get from making my own stuff, and it contributes to my success in the field. That's extremely satisfying. As you can see, I like to use plaid wool. That's always my first choice in the hunting garment. Got different colors here. Here's a little DIY modification I did some years ago. I will say my favorite camouflage pattern that's commercially available is the old school tree bark. I love it. So anyway, let's make some camouflage hunting clothes DIY style. All right, here's what I'm using. I'm using gray, white, tan, black, and brown spray paint from the dollar store. I cut out two different templates out of poster board, and I covered the poster board with contact paper to help protect it from the moisture of the paint. I have a 99-cent 3/4 zip pullover from a thrift store, and I have two pair of the BDU military pants, gray and beige. Let's paint them up. Okay, the first thing I always like to do is I like to work in layers. I do a light layer first, then I do a medium layer second, and a dark layer last. So we're going to start with this pattern right here. And this is really random and personal as far as how you want this to go. It's really up to the individual. Now what I do is I put these around where I'm going to paint to protect the garment from overspray, because I promise you I am not artistic. Go. Perfect. All right, we're going to start with white and tan. I like to mix these. Shake them up. And spray. Oops. All right, it's always good to have a backup. All right, shake them up. All right. Cool. And then all we do is we just move around the shirt until we have the entire base all over the shirt. All right, so we've got the first coat down. That's the first layer. Now we're going to go to the brown layer using a different pattern. Time for some brown. It's going to start taking shape now. All see what we got. Oh yeah. Sweet. I like it. And then we just keep moving around until it's the way we want it. Alright, as you can see, it's starting to take shape a little bit. Now we've got the third and final layer using black. Alright, I just finished with the last layer of the black. You can see took shape pretty good. I like it. And now all I do is let that dry a little bit, turn it over and do the back. Alright, we got it done. Here it is. I'm happy with it. See what you think of it. Okay. I think there's probably going to be a couple of questions come to mind. How long does it take to get the paint smell away, and how long does it last? Well, I made this shirt about 12 years ago. I let this thing dry for about a week, and then I washed it several times in cold water and let it air dry. And this is very comfortable. I've hunted in this thing. Got blood on it, washed it 100 times. This paint's not going anywhere. So if you were to do this, paint your stuff, let it air, just hang out somewhere to air dry for a week or so, and then just wash it a few times. Cold water, no detergent, and let it air dry. And you're good to go, man. Thanks for watching. All the best.